प्लीज स्विच ऑफ योर मोबाइल्स, दैट इज मस्ट, अदरवाइज सम गुड हिंदी और इंग्लिश सॉन्ग्स और कन्नडा सॉन्ग्स विल बी देयर इन द मिडिल ऑफ दैट. सो टिल नाउ ऑल फीमेल्स हैज टेकन द वर्कशॉप, फर्स्ट मेल इज टेकिंग वर्कशॉप फॉर यू. मैडम, she wants some help of you. देख लो ना. ठीक है, वाइब्रेशन मोड ऑल्सो नॉट एन इश्यू, सॉन्ग शुड नॉट कम. नया भी था
This is the full form, that scientific, technology, engineering and mathematics. And as the word suggests, that we will be using these four aspects to explain our concepts to the preschoolers. Now,
small experiments which the children can enjoy and learn something new.
Like the
हेलो 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 हेलो
या it okay now? For example, if you take this mic, so the basic structure, if you see the, I mean, before going for the manufacturing, they'll be thinking about the dimension. Okay, this should be the height of the mic, or this should be the diameter. Okay, so their max comes into picture. Okay, and like suppose say, if you take a projector, the light, like whatever you're projecting, is a basic principle is light. Without light, you can't display anything over here. So again, like the light is a natural source of energy. Like from sun, like we are getting the light, and that is known to everyone. That is getting altered little bit to show it as a projector, or to show it as a torch, or to show it as a television or something like that. So any it could be any equipment or anything, if you take the stem, comes as a basic principle actually. So our objective, like what we are planning to do, is to start this idea from the preschooling itself. Okay, you need to make the way of, I mean, the child is thinking, always, you know, that child starts learning like on a daily basis. Okay, so you're just adding a little bit kindling to it, to think a little bit like different actually. Little bit different means like whatever it sees, okay, if the kid is seeing this duster, he should think something different of the regular duster actually. That's how the creativity will grow automatically. If you put this initial seeding to the kid at the very beginning, it will start growing on its own. Okay, so for that, like if you, before explaining any concepts to the kid, you need to build the curiosity to it actually. So unless you build the curiosity to the kid, like you can't explain the concepts to them. Okay, so with that, like whenever you choose any stem, this any experiment, you need to, the basic one thing you need to keep into mind, like you don't need to make the kid to understand the technology completely. You need to create some curiosity. Suppose if you are making a rocket, balloon rocket or something, the kid should get some curiosity in that particular experiment. It should get attracted to it. So post to that, it will start thinking. When the kid start doing the same experiment in the next time, it will do some alteration to it. So that's how the skill set will keep growing automatically. So the initial attraction will be like, you need to choose the experiments in such a way that kids will get more attraction to it. Okay? So, and one more thing, like if we talk about STEM, science, technology, engineering and mathematics, all the four might look it's more or less mingled together actually. If you take anything, like if you talk about science and technology, or mathematics is inside that science actually. If you talk about engineering, science and maths are that mingled with that actually. So we don't need to confuse much about that. Just understand general. So just like extending, exploring the objects and items present in the natural environment. Natural environment means like you can see like water, sunlight, wind, okay, or insects. Insects means like living things, non-living things. Or if you take insects, like number of legs each insect is having. Or if you take a plant, like what are the types of plants, sort of thing, like with the nature, like you're not altering the nature, whatever you're seeing in the surrounding, with that you need to build the experiments actually. So that sort of experiments can come under the science category. For example, like wind is a normal one, like with wind, so many experiments we can build it actually. So simple things like if you want to know the intensity of the wind, or like how fast the wind is blowing, so with that you can build some small logic actually. So some 2-3 threads with some different weights, and you can ask the kid to blow slowly, blow fastly, and with the lesser weight string will move fast with a less air itself, and the heavy string will take more time. That's how you need to keep building on it actually in terms of science category. So science if you are choosing any experiment in the science, think like whatever you are seeing, like suppose say if you are taking a water bottle, okay, with the water you can do so many science experiments, okay, you can take the water bottle, put some three holes in the one by one, and if you fill the water at the top, the water will be flowing slowly, but at the bottom, the water will be flowing faster, sort of thing, okay. So there is no standard procedure or something, whichever makes the kid to think on it, you can just choose as an experiment actually, okay. And in terms of technology, okay, so you are doing some little bit modification to the science concept, okay, which will meet the human needs, got it? Making little bit modifications with the science concept which will meet the human needs. In case like so normally like in olden days if a human being want to cross from one bank one corner to another corner in a river or something, like he'll swim and cross the river, okay, whereas later on like he saw like floating woods on the water and all, like, and he just tried bundling the, he tried catching the wood and started crossing it, but it's not sufficient to hold his weight. It's getting sinked actually. So instead of that, he just tried adding 2-3 woods together and just make a heavier thing to float on it. So after that, he could be able to stand on it and cross the river. So that is the, so everything that wooden, everything's are naturally available things, and he customized it to fit his requirement actually. That's what we are calling it as technology. That is the beginning of the technology. So it's technology means not only like cell phone or mobile phones, our laptops, it's not like that actually. Whatever you're customizing from the nature things, those things you can classify as a technology concept. No need to write the notes. These things I'll be sharing it with you. And engineering. If you see the engineering things, like suppose for the same boat manufacturing, boat making concept itself, if one guy is done the boat making, the first stage actually, okay, proven, it's carrying that load and it's shifting to the other corner, everything is working fine. Suppose if the requirement is more, you want to make so many boats actually. So in that case, like, you need to make some procedure. Okay, step one, cut all the trees and remove the leaves and other things and all, and cut into this sort of shape. Okay, next, pile it with a rope or something into as a plane, and then make it float on the water and make sure that once you stand on it, it's not getting sinked completely, sort of things and all, like. So this step-by-step approach you are doing it actually. And you can have some test mechanism. That is like you're making sure whether it's not getting sick once you stand on it. That's a testing mechanism. Once you write these steps, that comes the engineering. So once the steps are written, you can throw away the steps to anyone who can start. Once you give the steps to anyone else, like a formula, he can start manufacturing the boats actually. Okay? That's what we're calling it as engineering. Okay? So in kids, like suppose for a kid, if you want to make an engineering concept, like give the task to the kids so that like once they start doing it, they should get the engineering skills also. It should be unknowingly. You can't teach it as a concept or something. They won't understand the concept. But if you teach them in steps or the related experiments, they'll start capturing those ideas actually. So mathematics. So whenever you're giving the task, it should be like, whoever we are going to deal is like below 6 years actually. So even like we can't expect them to know numbers more than like 50 or 10. In some cases, they can tell the numbers from 1 to 10. Okay, that's the maximum thing. Like if you are at the very beginning, say 2 years or 3 years, if you're talking about. So, and with them, like with using the numbers itself, we need to, start giving the task in such a way that they'll do some additions and subtraction out of that. They won't be knowing what they are doing. They don't need to know they are doing addition or subtraction or something like that. But your task should be in such a way that they need to learn the addition and subtraction skills automatically. So it should be like they'll be interested to play. Like you might have seen like kids used to, when you give a car, like they'll be interested to, like no need to be a remote controlled car and all. Like if it is a car with the wheels, they'll just keep start holding it and keep dragging it on the all over the way and all. If you put some little bit rules to it, okay, do like this, do like this. And if you put some kind of learning task on top of that, it becomes a learning methodology. Okay? And like measurements and data in geometry. So you can like, when you're interacting with kids, like you can give them some three, four objects and ask them to sense it actually. Yeah, just let me know which is the heaviest of these two. So they can just sense with their hand, like they can predict it. Post to the prediction, you can ask, give them a weighing balance kind of thing, like, and I'll ask them to put the weight in both the pans, and they can cross verify it.